Hi, guys. My name's Chris Trujillo. I'm the production designer here on Stranger Things. So this season, tonally, we wanted it to feel kind of, the colors are meant to be very organic, but bruised. So there's a lot of very deep purples and reds, and you feel like there's just kind of just pervading gloom, you know, everywhere. The Creel House this year was the home of this character, and essentially he is psychically responsible for this mindscape space. We see it in a 1959 version, and we see it in a present-day dilapidated version.
Yeah, that's not creepy.
And then we spend some time there in the Upside Down. We have fragment elements of the Creel House that we're kind of twisting and distorting and breaking apart, and in a way directly related to the Upside Down. The Demogorgon Pit is an epic set. It serves the function of sort of this gladiatorial arena. So our challenge was figuring out how to justify a space that has these sort of oversized dimensions. There's this exterior kind of walkway area that's all just incredibly bleak, rusted metal, and these ancient brick and plaster walls. The door opens and reveals the Demogorgon. There's a little case that is meant to be full of makeshift gladiatorial weapons. It's cool. It's super cool.
Ooh, I think I found our morning movie. Dr. Zhivago.
You know I don't do double VHS.
We spent a lot of time trying to figure out what we were going to do with the video store. We didn't know if it was going to become such an important plot point, and the interior is pretty great. The video store is a very clear and blatant expression of everything that inspires the show, you know? We spent some time in the Wheeler House, both in the Upside Down and in the real world. It's always been a part of how we have conceived of the mythology of the Upside Down and the kind of the rules and the physics of the Upside Down. The moment that the Upside Down was quote unquote created inadvertently by Eleven, the set dressing and the world of the Upside Down is frozen in that moment. So like when we're in Nancy's room, we'll discover in the Upside Down that Nancy's room is as it was season one when we first were introduced to it.
What is it?
The last entry is November 6, 1983, the day Will went missing, the day the gate opened.
Mike goes to California with these sort of unrealistic expectations, this sort of Midwesterner's idea of what California is all about. We want to have all of the textures of that sort of SoCal desert so we can get into these really great kind of colors that we haven't seen before and light quality that we haven't seen before. I think the pizza mobile, you know, is going to be a lot of fun. We've spent a lot of time trying to figure that out. We started with this really small, bizarre van that we love and we completely decked out, only to find out that it is a little bit tight for what we're trying to do inside of it.
Hold on to your butts, bro chachos.
So now we've changed it to a VW van again, which is equally as amazing and super fun in terms of the shape and the way the door opens and all that stuff. The logo is a big sign that sits on top of the van, and we'll have the option of internally lighting it. So it's essentially like a big simplified surfboard. We've all been doing this together for so long that we've really learned each other, and each one of us can have confidence in the other's work.
Chris and I see things the same, so it's always been an easy thing to collaborate and create worlds. And every year it grows, and so it's new challenges.
I think the sets and thereby the world of Hawkins is just looking better and better as far as the craft goes. As designers and decorators and art directors, we've all kind of facilitated each other's development. And I think it's true kind of across the board, you know, with everybody who's been making this show for all these years.